Welcome back to Embedded World. My name is Robin M. Saltness, Product Marketing Engineer and Trade Show Vlogger at Nordic Semiconductor. First thing I did when entering the show was to go see my old friend Ville's mother. You know, she gets shit done, and that's what I needed to do as well. On my way to the Nordic booth, I got distracted by the DigiKey booth, where they had sort of a service desk with electronic tools to measure and fix your devices. They also had this little demo with an LED matrix that reacted to a gyro like it was sand or something, which I thought was pretty cool. Then I caught up with Finn, who was over at the Amazon Web Services booth, playing chess against a robot? I'm a little bit confused, but it works like this. You make your moves on an interface that's suspiciously similar to chess.com, and then these robot arms actually move the pieces on a real chessboard for you, which was pretty cool. But the computer was a little bit strong for Finn, so he lost. Then I walked over to Analog Devices and looked at their emergency lighting demo, which uses, of course, an nrf52840 as their connectivity, and it also had redundant power supplies for emergencies, naturally. We then went over to AntennaWare that showed us how they send audio over Bluetooth LE.
Okay, so this is the version AntennaWare wireless microphone demonstrator. So it's based on the Nordic nrf5340. It can be used for various types of wireless technologies, but in this case we're using Bluetooth LE, and we've got the Vive On Air proprietary RF protocol, which sits on top of this, and this helps you deliver very low latency, and we're demonstrating 3.8 milliseconds here. Yeah, so the applications would be sort of real-time wireless microphones, so, and you can actually notice the latency, so it's good for those kind of applications.
There was, of course, a lot of Nordic partners using Nordic products and parts in their devices and booths. Here is Leber. It's a German design house that makes devices for their customers. They're proudly displaying that they have shown proficiency in using Nordic products, so they become an official design partner. Here's one of the devices they made. Then we have Irnas, that you know, of course, from last year's video. They were also displaying that they're a Nordic design partner. Memfault, our partner in remote debugging, was both displaying our logo, and they also used a Thingy91 for showcasing their remote debugging functionality. Then you have Packetcraft. They were also using Thingy53s in this case for their demo. Here you have module maker Esurio, previously known as Laird. If you need a Nordic module, this is one of the places you can go. And the award for most Nordic logos in one booth, I think, would go to Raytac, also a module maker. They had all the Nordic logos because they're using all the Nordic parts in their modules. And they even have modules for the brand new 54 series, coming soon, TM. I also visited the Zephyr booth. I tried to get a word in with Torbjörn, but he was super busy. We are a platinum member of Zephyr, of course, so we had our own stand at their booth. Then I got to do a few video interviews with Electromaker over at the Nordic booth, so if you want more info on the machine learning demo or the power management demo from our booth, you can go over to the Electromaker channel and watch those videos there. Also at the Nordic booth, we got visited by our new friend Jukka from Radiantum that showed us the Frolf disc they made for their customer GameProofer.
This is actually one of my favorite ones because it's my favorite hobby. It's a disc you can throw for disc golfing, and I have my friend here from Radiantum to actually explain what they did, why they did it, and why it's so amazing. So go ahead.
Yeah, so we at Radiantum, we are specialized on the RF and EMC integration. So this is our customer product where we did the hardware development for the sensor. So we do have inside here this 52840. IC, and it's fully custom designed, so there's no socket inside, because you need to perfectly balance because of the sport. You have the balance, you have to place the all the hardware so that within the battery, within the wireless charging and all the other ICs, it remains like perfectly balanced, so you get the information. What is special for the product is that because we are specialized for the connectivity and antenna design, this device has more than 150 meter range outdoors, so when you throw it, there's not so many people in the world who will throw more than 150 meters. So this will communicate with your phone throughout the whole flight, and it will tell you how fast your hand is moving before you release, how fast the disc is spinning, what's the nose angle, wobble, speed, how long the throw was.
Yeah.
Everything what you need to develop your throw.
And you get some really nice information. You told me before about the maximum G-forces you measured.
Oh, yeah,
which
true.
My guess was like 10 to 20 Gs. You can write your guesses in the comments. So what's the actual G-forces you measured?
Yeah, that was a surprise also during the development that 2 years ago we started the thing, and we have this 16G sensor in the product. And we threw it like this, amateurs threw it, we didn't have any problems. Then we gave it first time to the professionals, and all the axles were on the max, and so we couldn't measure anymore. So the actual maximum what we have measured in the throw by a Finnish thrower was more than 180 Gs when the release is happening.
Yeah.
It's not only the sensors what is getting all the information, you have also the location, and if you lost your disc, you can actually look from the app.
Yeah.
And you can get the location so that there's a specific app where you can get all the data.
Mm-hmm.
So if you are this backhand, forehand, how long it was, how fast your arm was moving, and how fast your disc is moving at the release.
Yeah.
So this, all the information you will get during the flight already. Before the disc lands, you have the information. Of course, then you can analyze more after the flight.
Yeah.
Of drone.
And that's all we had from Embedded World 2024. I hope to see you at our booth next year at Embedded World 2025. I'll leave you off with some pictures of our booth and our handsome booth staffers hard at work showing demos to potential customers. This, for example, is the LE Audio demo showcasing the new audio on Bluetooth LE features. Here you can also see our hexagon wall displaying end products using Nordic parts, pretty cool. Thanks for watching, and I hope to see you at our booth next year.